In a rather unusual move, so to say, both India's DGMO, the Director General of Military Operations of India, and that of Pakistan, who, by the way, talk to each other regularly, at least once every week, have talked about peace. Now, if you were watching what was happening along the line of control or the international border, it is, you know, you would know that things have been unusually hot. The ceasefire agreement that we had with Pakistan since 2003, the peace and tranquility agreement, existed in paper as both sides went after each other. Hundreds of villages across the international border, which is mainly in the Jammu side, had been vacated, and same on the other side of Pakistan. Each were targeting and there were no holds barred. We have used anti-tank missiles to target their posts. They have used anti-tank missiles to target our posts. Videos released subsequently both by the Indian Army and the Pakistan Army have, you know, given a very clear understanding of the kind of devastation and destruction that have been happening around the along the border. Thousands of people in the villages along the international border have had to evacuate. There have been fresh and renewed demands for building bunkers. In this backdrop, why talk peace? Now, it's very interesting because at one end, you have the Ramadan ceasefire going on. The government all of a sudden unexpectedly came out after a cabinet meeting about a week ago saying that 1 month of ceasefire so that people of Jammu and Kashmir can, you know, can go through Ramadan, can introspect, and perhaps the government expects that they will come back to the main fold, and, you know, the angst and anger that was developing in the valley would quieten down. That is one part of it. And we see the other part of the jigsaw puzzle today coming out with the both military saying that let us go back to the 2003 agreement and let us try to keep the borders quiet. Now, this is definitely connected. The reason there is another part of the jigsaw. We saw Prime Minister Modi make a rather uncharacteristic move, and that what is what defines the Modi government's diplomacy. He went across to China and had an informal summit with the Chinese Premier President Xi Jinping, where the two said, let's again cool down the borders. Now, what we saw with China last year, the Doklam Plateau in Bhutan, an unprecedented 72-day standoff, tense atmosphere with both sides, again cool down. So across, you see a pattern. You're seeing the northern borders, we're trying to cool it down, and also the western borders, we're trying to cool it down and bring some sanity. Now, all this why? Perhaps, and this is what people are talking about, with the 2019 elections coming, the government really doesn't want the borders to be as tense as it were, or as it were in the last few months. And therefore, it is taking these reconciliatory steps to kind of quieten down the borders. Will talks happen with Pakistan? Will there be a summit level talks with Pakistan? Now, we've heard contradictory statements coming out from the government. Home Minister saying, yes, we are ready to talk. The External Affairs Minister saying that, no, we will not talk as long as there is terror. So there is some kind of division still there. But the mechanisms that have developed over the years with Pakistan, whether it is talks with the BSF or with the coast guards of the two countries, or the DGMO level talks, which happens, by the way, every week, continues. So for the moment, we can safely say, while a composite dialogue between the two leaders may not happen, or composite dialogue between India and Pakistan may not start, but there is definitely a step to kind of cool down the tempers and, you know, step back, think about it, and perhaps we, in the near future, we may also see a huge step being taken by India to kind of bring bring the trust deficit or the gap that has been developing over the last few years to some kind of a even keel.